Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you some better ways to view recent files on your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So often when we're working with our Macs, we want to go right to a file that we were just working with. And in the Finder, there's an easy way to do this. Usually in your favorites here, you've got recent. And you select that and it shows you all of your files sorted by date last opened. The list can be huge and it can contain a lot of things that you don't necessarily want to get right back to. I typically don't even have recents here. I go into Finder Preferences sidebar and turn it off. But you can create your own recents functionality here that's more selective, that only shows you truly recent files and maybe files only of certain types. So to do this, we're going to do a saved search, also known as a smart folder. So you can start one many different ways, but I'm going to go to File, New Smart Folder. But first, I'm going to check my current location. So I'm going to start in my iCloud Drive folder because I have all my files in iCloud Drive. You could start anywhere that you like. If you have everything that you need for a particular search in a subfolder, you can start there. Now I'm going to go to File, New Smart Folder. And you could see the search starts either in this Mac or iCloud Drive, the location I was previously at. So I'm going to make sure iCloud Drive is selected and then I'm going to start my search. I'm not going to worry about searching for something specific here. I want to see all files that are pretty recent. So instead I'm going to use the plus button here to add some new search criteria. I'm going to go to the criteria type here and I'm going to choose either last open date or last modified date. If you don't see what you want in this list, you can go to other and everything is here. So if I search for modified, for instance, I could see last modified date right there and okay. And say it's within the last, and let's say 90 days. So I'm not going to see all of my files going back forever, just things that I've modified in the last 90 days. Now depending upon your use, you really may want to go to last open date. There may be files that you never modified but you open and refer to all the time. So you'll see the temporary results right here, but I'm not done yet. I also want to restrict the file types here. So let's say I only want to see spreadsheets. I'm going to use the plus button here again and I'm going to go to kind. And you may have to go to other to find kind. And instead of any, I'm going to select the type. So I could say PDF or presentation like a keynote document, but I'm going to choose other. And I could type a file extension here or an app name. And then I'm going to type numbers as the application. And I'm going to see three number spreadsheets appear here. So not only will this smart folder remember the search criteria here, but also remember the columns and the sorting. I want to sort by date modified, but that's not listed right here. So I'm going to control click on any one of these headings here and add date modified. I'm going to control click again. Let's remove date opened. I don't care about size in this view and I don't care about kind because they're all numbers documents. So I just have name and date modified. Then I'm going to click on date modified to sort. So right now it's sorting by the most recent first, but I could click here to go the other way if I want. So now I've got things set up like I want. I can save this. I'll click the save button here and I'm going to save this in its default location, which is in your home folder, library folder, saved searches. And I'm going to call this recent numbers documents, or you could call it recent spreadsheets. And then I'm going to make sure add to sidebar is checked. When I save, not only is it going to save the search to that location, which I'll never really go to, but it's going to add it here to favorites. I'm going to move it here to the top. So it's at the top. So now anytime I want to view my recent spreadsheets, wherever I am in the Finder, I just go to this and it goes to it. And you can see here, it remembers I only wanted to see name, date modified, sorted by date modified with the most recent first. And this will automatically update to show me my most recent numbers documents. I can always modify this by control clicking here in favorites. And I could go to show search criteria and it brings all that back up. So if I wanted to say change to 120 days or only 30 days, I could. And I could also change other things. So for instance, let's say I want to do a combo kind of search. Maybe I'm always wanting to see numbers files and PDFs. That's what I primarily work with. So let's make this both. Now if I add another item here to the criteria, I can do kind and I could say is, and there actually is a selection for PDF, so I'll just use that. And notice now it shows nothing, which doesn't seem right because I know there were three numbers files that fit within the last 90 days. So why is it now nothing? Well, it's doing a and here. It's got to be kind as numbers and kind as PDF, which of course is impossible. What I want to do is an or, kind as either numbers or a PDF. So I'm going to go back over here to these buttons and I'm going to go to the line above these two. I'm going to hold the Option key down and you can see the plus changes to three dots. When I click it, now I get this little any of the following are true or all or none of the following are true. So using any, I can list several things underneath here and if one of them is true, then it will find that document. So it starts off with name matches. I don't need that. I just need the kind as numbers or kind as PDF. I can actually drag these by grabbing just to the left there and drag them up. And let's get rid of the name matches. I didn't need that. So now it's last modified dates within the last 90 days and any of these things are true. The kind is either numbers or the kind is PDF. So now I see numbers and PDF files all sorted by date modified all within the last 90 days. Let's go and change this by control clicking and then rename. And now I can rename it. So instead of recent spreadsheets I can call this recent docs or recent spreadsheets and PDFs, whatever I want. And now I've got the name change. I've set up new criteria. I'll hit the save button here. And now wherever I am, if I'm somewhere else, I can click on recent docs and it'll actually show me exactly what I want. I could also control click on this and notice there's add to doc. When I do that, it adds this as a doc item here, which is really handy to have. So you can see how easy this is to change. Don't be afraid to change it on a regular basis. Like for instance, for a while, maybe at the end of the year, I want to review all of the year's documents. I can go into here, show search criteria, change this to 400 days and get 400 days, save. And then when I'm done and I want to go back to the 90 days, just go back in again and set it to 90 days. It's pretty easy to modify. When you have multiple file types like this, a useful thing to do is turn grouping on. You can do that in View, Use Groups, and then go back to View again and Group By and select Kind, or you can go right to it here in this button in the toolbar. So when grouped by kind, you can see spreadsheets and PDF documents are separate. Now this is very useful here where you have a limited number of files, where I've said I only want 90 days and I want these two file types. If I were to go to Recents here, which you can also get to in the Go menu, and I were to use grouping there, it's not nearly as useful. You get documents, which goes on forever, and then you get all sorts of other groups down here, like movies and music and things like that. And this list is just too long to make grouping by kind useful. But the short Recent Docs Smart folder I created works really well with grouping. So instead of creating recent numbers documents and recent PDFs, I can just do recent docs, have both spreadsheets and PDF documents in here, have them grouped, and now in one location I can see both things. I could probably add three or four different file kinds and it would still be useful. Now you can do one-off searches either here in the Finder in the search field or in Spotlight with Command Space. You could search for things like kind and then colon and then let's say numbers and you would get those results. You can't ask for files modified in the last 30 days or 90 days, but you can do a date range. So you could do either created or modified and then a colon and then you can give a date range. So let's say 1/1/2021 2/7/8/2021 and then you get those results. Or you could say greater than and equal to and then a date like that. Siri can actually do a little better as you can specify a number of days. Show me numbers files modified in the last 90 days.
Here are all of the files that were modified between April 8th, 2021 and today.
And you can click here to open that in the Finder. So I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.